available stop is going to be Mickey's Toontown Depot. As a friendly reminder, our New Orleans Square station is currently closed due to construction we have going on at the Haunted Mansion, so there will be no boarding nor disembarking at New Orleans Square. As once again, our New Orleans Square station is currently closed.
Welcome aboard the Disneyland Railroad. We're embarking on a grand circle tour of the Magic Kingdom. We'll be stopping at New Orleans Square, Mickey's Toontown, and Tomorrowland. We'll also visit the Grand Canyon and make a trip back in time to the primeval world and the age of the dinosaurs before returning to Main Street Station. As we begin our journey, remember that for a safe trip, you need to stay seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. And please watch your children.
Bienvenidos a bordo del Disneyland Railroad. Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los pequeños. Gracias.
Our first stop is New Orleans Square Station. But to get there, we need to pass through the wilds of Adventureland. It may seem peaceful through here, but trust me, it's a real jungle out there. Literally. So be on the lookout. You just never know what might be lurking along the rails. Just ahead is New Orleans Square Station. This station also serves Frontierland and Critter Country. If you'll be leaving us, complete stop. Then watch your step as you're getting off. For those of you continuing on with us, we'll be resuming our trip in just a moment. This is New Orleans Square Station. New Orleans Square.
Once again, this station is currently closed. There will be no boarding or disembarking right here at New Orleans Square. Once again, New Orleans Square Station is currently closed. Our next available stop is going to be Mickey's Toontown Depot. The train does need to stop here just to change out our engineer crews and fill up our engine with some water. As soon as those things are done, this train's going to move, so please remain seated. Like we said, our next stop, it'll be our gateway to Fantasyland, Toontown, and Star Wars, Galaxy's Edge.
To those just joining us, welcome aboard the Disneyland Railroad. To ensure a safe ride, stay seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. And please watch your kids.
Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los pequeños.
We're now entering the bayou, soon to be home to Tiana's Bayou Adventure. Princess Tiana swears there's magic out here. And wherever there's magic, there's bound to be surprises. Blue skies and sunshine guaranteed. Speaking of surprises, this place we're passing over is chock full of them. Here in Critter Country, you can join Winnie the Pooh, Tigger, and other beloved critters on fun-filled adventures, where anything can happen.
Oh, look, you're right there. That's right. That's really cute. This is the first ride that we ever took Eddie's son when she was a baby. Last time we've been on that, they're all scared of it. Yeah.
As we steam past Hungry Bear Restaurant, the last outpost in these parts, we're now joining up with the rivers of America and entering the frontier as it looked more than a century and a half ago. This is my favorite part of the journey. Around every bend, there's natural beauty as far as the eye can see. People like you have been riding these rails since the 1800s, traveling through nature's wonderland in a matter of days, rather than the months it would take by mule or stagecoach. Steam power not only fueled these iron horses, but the dreams of a whole new generation as it moved west into this great frontier. Of course, some of those dreams, and the stories that went with them, were pretty darn wild and downright unbelievable. Like on Big Thunder Mountain, where I hear that mysterious spirits have grabbed hold of those mining trains and turned them into the wildest ride in the wilderness. Signals our transition from the frontier to another kind of gear, the ones you'll find on Mickey and Minnie Mouse. Our next stop is Toontown Depot, official train station for Mickey's Toontown, the cartoon home where Mickey, Minnie, and all their friends live. Toontown Depot is also the gateway to Fantasyland, where you'll find many of your favorites.
Well, as the station waiter finally asks you, remain seated until the train has come to its full and complete stop. So here's Mickey's Toontown Depot. It's your stop for Fantasyland attractions like It's a Small World, the Matterhorn Bobsleds, Peter Pan Flight, the Tea Party, and so much more. Also, this is your stop for Star Wars, Galaxy's Edge. So if you're folks heading to Star Wars the land, this will be the closest the train can get to. Once again, please remain seated until the train has come to a full and complete stop.
Thank you. seated with your seatbelt fastened. Permanecer sentados.
Second stern to the right, straight on for more.
Journey to Storybook Land. My name is Tannery, and I'll be your captain and your storyteller aboard the Alice. For your safety, please remain seated with those hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the boat at all times, and supervise any little ones so that our story doesn't take any unexpected turns. Now, most people travel to the enchanted world through the pages of a book, but for those who visit in person, whether it be down the rabbit hole or the little pixie dust, often find a way in to be quite magical. Or sometimes medicine. But don't worry, after passing through the jaws, monster whale, the same whale that swallowed Pinocchio, we're actually being transported to a magical place called Storybook Land. Now our story begins with a big bad wolf who lives in a cave just to our left. But luckily, those three little pigs lived right across the way in those three houses, where one was made out of straw, the second was made out of sticks, and the last one was made out of wolf fruit guaranteed bricks. But then our story takes a strange turn as we are now headed toward a quaint English village that's home to Alice, where one golden afternoon, she chased the white rabbit down the rabbit hole, where she fell down into Wonderland. Storybook Land is full of fantastic places. Places like London Park, over which Peter Pan, John, Wendy, and Michael Darling all flew over, and to Neverland, where they would never, ever grow up. Or places like Agrabah, city of mystery and magic, where a street rat named Aladdin first met Princess Jasmine in the street market where he stole her heart. Although the two are from two different worlds, thanks to the power of love and the help from a genie, the two got married and now live in the Sultan's palace. Although stories are full of love and light, they also have their dark places as well. Just like the Cave of Wonders up ahead, its treasure bears a curse that can only be lifted by the genie of the lamp. And legend says, whoever sets the genie free will be granted three wishes. Snow White wished for a safe place to go after she fled from the evil queen, where she came across a small, cozy cottage in the forest that belongs to the Seven Dwarfs, where they offered her shelter in exchange for her kindness. And on our left, we have Cinderella, who wished to go to the ball, but her wicked stepmother forbid her from going. Thankfully, her fairy godmother came to the rescue and granted her that wish. However, when Cinderella failed to return home by midnight, her carriage turned back into a pumpkin. Dreams can come true. Like wishes, they inspire our stories. Some dream of a happily ever after, while others dream of falling asleep in hills of COVID flowers. Just like the ones to our left, inspired by the 1933 Silly Symphony cartoon, Bubba by Land. There's magic everywhere here in Storybook Land, even in the miniature plants that will forever stay small, thanks to the magic of Tinkerbell. And that's just what made this place a favorite of master storyteller, and continues to inspire new stories every day. Stories like The Wind in the Willows, with Mole, Rat, and Mr. Toad. The stately manor is on our left-hand side. But sorry folks, Mr. Toad isn't home right now, as he's off in his motor car on a wild ride to nowhere in particular. Or stories of magic like that in Arendelle, where Elsa fled to the icy mountain tops. But her sister Anna refused to let her go, and that act of true love saved them both. Up ahead in the Alpine village, woodcarver named Geppetto wished upon a star for his puppet to turn into a real boy. And thanks to the blue fairy, his wish came true. Geppetto's wish is like those made in so many fairy tales, like that of a little mermaid named Ariel, who wished to follow Prince Eric to his castle on our right. She gave up her life under the sea and became a part of our world. Now her story begins in the underwater city of Atlanta, just to our left, where she spilled out to a happily ever after. So now we're coming to a close on our story. Please remain seated with both hands, arms, and fingers inside the boat. And when we come to a stop at the dock, remain seated until my count of three so that we can all stand up together at once and balance out the boat so no one has to go under the sea.
Thank you. Welcome aboard, folks. We're ready for a relaxing ride around the world.
Yeah.
Seated, keeping hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. Please be sure to supervise your children. Keep them away from the edge of the benches and the openings of the train, ensuring that they too are seated at this time. Our next stop is going to be Tomorrowland Station. It will be your gateway to the future. As a friendly reminder, our New Orleans Square Station is currently closed due to construction we have going on at the Haunted Mansion. There will be no boarding nor disembarking at New Orleans Square, as once again, our New Orleans Square Station is currently closed.
And please watch your kids.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Y bienvenidos a bordo. Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los pequeños. Gracias.
As we leave Toontown Depot, we get a real nice view of the happiest land of them all, Fantasyland. You can see people stepping onto It's a Small World just below us. And, off in the distance, majestic Matterhorn Mountain.
Look at Small World. Please remain seated until
the boat comes to a complete halt.
Steaming forward into the future to a land inspired by visions of tomorrow, both practical and imagined. Here you'll find rocket ships and star steamers, submarines and astroblasters, and if you look overhead, maybe a glimpse of a Mark 7 monorail. This is the latest version of the first daily operating monorail system in the entire Western Hemisphere, gliding above Disneyland since 1959. Below the monorail, and and us are the fun-filled roadways of the Autopia. Drivers of all ages.
Once again, parents, please ensure that all small children are fully seated, either on your lap or on the bench next to you, but let us be sitting at all times.
Spaceships or doing battle with evil empires and emperors, Tomorrowland is definitely the place for you.
Once again, parents, your small child must be fully seated, either on your lap or on the bench next to you, but they must be sitting at all times. Thank you.
Gather your belongings, including lightsabers and astroblasters, and step carefully from the train. Thanks, and have fun in the future. For the rest of you, just sit tight. We'll be on our way again in just a minute.
Retrieve the power cells, while the rest of you concentrate on those robots.
Have been temporarily halted. Please remain seated. Your mission will resume shortly. Prepare to resume your mission.
My treasure, but not my soul. No one can stop me. you've got.
Proceed directly across the ramp into the cabin. Continue to move all the way across your aisle, filling in every available seat.
All passengers, please prepare for immediate boarding.
Takeoff sequence initiated.
R2-D2, what's going on here? We are not ready for takeoff. The captain isn't on board yet.
You never can fly this thing.
No, neither can you. We need a proper pilot.
All transport hold.
Those stormtroopers will be deactivated for sure.
Hold it right there, Captain.
I'm not actually the captain.
We're looking for this rebel spy. Have you seen him?
No one on this transport could possibly be a spy. Dear.
This is the speeder we're looking for. Blast off!
Not this way, Arthur!
Greetings.
Scorpio, R2. You're traveling with a friend of mine that has vital information for the rebellion.
The spy? I knew it.
Head to the rendezvous point I'm sending you. Good luck, Star Tours. And may the Force be with you.
Just a moment, R2. Let us consider this.
Your safety restraints by pressing the release button on your left. Make sure you have all your personal belongings as you exit. Thank you for flying Star Tours. Bye-bye.
To the left of the monorail. Thanks for traveling with us today, and we hope you enjoy your visit to the Disneyland Resort. For those of you continuing with us, we'll begin our return trip to Tomorrowland in just a few minutes. Thank you. To those of you who have just joined us, welcome aboard the Disneyland monorail. For your safety, please remain seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the cabin. Watch your children, and no smoking, please.
Bienvenidos a bordo. Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los niños. Por favor, se ruega no fumar. Gracias.
We're now en route to our final stop, the Tomorrowland Monorail Station. Along the way, you can get a bird's eye look at the downtown Disney District, Disney's Grand Californian Hotel and Spa, and Disney California Adventure. To the left of the monorail is the main entrance of Disneyland, the happiest place on Earth. Disneyland is truly an American original. Since its opening in 1955, it has hosted hundreds of millions of guests from around the world, including presidents, kings, and celebrities. It is the original Disney theme park, created and enjoyed by Walt Disney himself. To the right is our transportation plaza, where you'll find taxis, hotel shuttles, and public transit stops. Inside the cabin. Science fact and fantasy. Below us is the submarine lagoon, where you can dive into a fantastic underwater adventure aboard the Finding Nemo submarine voyage. Across the way are the icy peaks of Matterhorn Mountain, home of the world's most famous bobsled run. And beneath us is the Autopia, where drivers of all ages can travel the road to tomorrow. Spires of one of Disney's most beloved attractions. It's a Small World. And now we're riding alongside the happiest kingdom of them all, Fantasyland, home to Pinocchio, Snow White, Peter Pan, and other storybook characters. The Tomorrowland monorail station, our final destination. Please remain seated until the monorail comes to a complete stop. Then collect your belongings, watch your head, and step carefully from the train. On behalf of all of our crew, thanks for traveling with us, and we hope you'll have a happy and memorable visit here at Disneyland. This is the Tomorrowland monorail station.
Yeah. G'day, this is the captain speaking. Now that we're underway, I'd like to welcome you aboard. As the conditions of our voyage may be unpredictable, please remain seated at all times. Stand by to dive.
Diving station.
Main induction closed. Pressure in the boat. The main ballast tanks. Let's take her down.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Dive. Dive. Trim about diving planes. 3 degrees.
Trim about diving planes. 3 degrees down.
Take her down easy. Catch her at 10 fathoms. Speed 06 at 1/2 knots.
06 at 1/2.
Steer 30 degrees.
Right bar, 30 degrees.
All ahead full. Steady as she goes.
All ahead full.
As we leave the coast behind and head towards open water, you'll notice that this is a popular spot for divers searching for exotic fish. Right rudder, 20 degrees. Set course directly over the Lost City.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Our destination today is quite extraordinary, a newly erupting deep water volcano. Even here in the shallows, we can see evidence of such geothermal forces constantly at work. You can tell by our surroundings that they can make some pretty dramatic changes to the landscape. These remnants of an ancient civilization were hidden for centuries beneath the ocean floor. Until unearthed by a tremendous volcanic event.
Steer 40 degrees.
Right rudder, 40 degrees.
Mind your distance to port and starboard.
Aye, aye, sir.
As we leave this long-lost community behind, the colourful reefs around us is a biological community that thrives in warm, shallow waters. It usually takes more than a year for a coral to grow only 1 inch. An amazing fact when you consider that Australia's Great Barrier Reef stretches over 2,000 kilometres. Such as our sonar hydrophones to actually hear the fish talk.
Why? Oh, where are you, sir?
Too deep for you, man.
Seen who?
Bruce. Remember the pledge.
Right, then. I am a nice shark, not a mindless eating machine. These are friends, not food. Right there, mates. Easy does it. You wouldn't want one of these balloons to pop.
Approaching our home port. We've enjoyed having you aboard.
on this adventurous voyage. Thanks for joining us, and have a top day.
Legs inside the train, please be sure to supervise your children, keep them away from the edge of the benches and the openings of the train, ensuring that they are seated at this time. Our next stop is going to be Main Street Station. Now before we get to Main Street though, we are going to go through a tunnel. As we enter the tunnel, we do kindly ask that there is no flash photography or video lighting. As a courtesy to the people around you, once again, please no lights in the tunnel up ahead. Also, as a friendly reminder, our New Orleans Square station is currently closed due to construction we have going on at the Haunted Mansion. There will be no boarding or disembarking at New Orleans Square. As once again, our New Orleans Square station is currently closed.
You're here next to me? No way.
Which one? The New Orleans station, the other one that we went to try to go to.
It's so many floors.
We had to walk all the way over to the other.
Make sure all little ones are fully seated when the train's in motion. Little ones are fully seated and we'll get off the train.
To those who have just come aboard, welcome. The next leg of our journey.
Hi, friends in the very back there. Make sure that your child is fully seated at all times, please. They cannot be standing up. Make sure that they are fully seated. Thank you.
Safety. Stay seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. Watch your children and no flash photography.
Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Cuide a los pequeños. Por favor, no tome fotografías sin flash.
Today. But it wasn't always this way. Now, let's travel back in time, way back in time, to the fantastic past of the primeval world, land of the dinosaurs. our own time and to Main Street Station, gateway to Disneyland. If you're leaving us here, stay in your seat until we come to a full stop. Remember to gather all your personal belongings and step carefully from the train. I'd especially like to thank those of you who've been with me for the Grand Circle Tour of Disneyland. We hope you enjoyed your travel.
The station would kindly ask you to continue to remain seated until the train has come to a full and complete stop. This right here is Main Street Station. It's your stop for the park entrance, downtown Disney, Adventureland, Frontierland, Critter Country. Once again, please remain seated until the train has come to a full and complete stop.
When you stand up,
once again remain seated at all times. We're going to be going down Main Street at a whopping speeds of 5 miles an hour, so please hang on. Close for your safety, please remain seated until the bus comes to a full and complete stop, and I have turned off the engine indicator to safe to disembark.
I know.
eyes of the idol. That would be dangerous. Very dangerous. Well, my friends, your moment is drawing near. Already I am envious of the wonders that await you, if you avoid the eyes of Mara, that is. You have chosen wise. This path leads to timeless youth and beauty.
Right hand side, we have the Temple of the Forbidden Eye. Does anyone know why it's called the Temple of the Forbidden Eye? No. Because the Temple of the Forbidden Me is bad grammar. Inside of that temple right now, Indiana Jones is searching for treasure. Don't know why though, because you all are right here. Oh. And there's our first sign of wildlife, folks. Yeah. Over here on the left-hand side, we have the crocodile pool in the ancient temple. Ooh, and up here is my favorite crocodile named Ginger. Everyone say hi, Ginger. Be careful, because Ginger snaps. She is one tough cookie, so you might want to keep your arms inside the boat. All right, right up here, we have the elephant bathing pool. It's all right to stare, everyone. They've got their tongues on. And over here we have one who's been in the shower for a little too long. She's all wrinkled, so she might want to see a pack of dermatologists. Alright, over here on our right hand side we have Squirt the baby elephant coming up to say hello. Alright, let's say hi back to Squirt, and oh, she's aiming for us. Let's get out of here. That was very smart in the back, hiding behind that small child. And up here we have, oh, that was not supposed to happen, everyone. It looks like monkeys have taken over this camp. Your car has gone by. I hope nothing bad has happened to my car. Well, they got my car to turn over. That's not great. And over here on the left-hand side, we are about to approach Schweitzer Falls. Named after the famous explorer Albert Falls. And now we're entering the Nile River, the longest river in the world, everyone. It just goes on for Niles and Niles and Niles and Niles. And if you don't believe me, then you're in the Nile. Up here we have the African elephant. Does anyone know why they're called African elephants? Because we're in Africa. We have some scientists on this boat, everyone. Right up here, we are approaching the African elk. Home to dozens of species, including giraffes, lions, zebras, and the mountain lion. The apex predator of the jungle. Oh, and would you look at that? The lions are watching over that sleeping zebra. Oh, she looks dead tired, so let's let her rest in peace. And right over here on the right-hand side, we have Skipper Felix and his crew in a tough situation. Hopefully he gets the point not to get out of his boat in the middle of the cruise. It's his first day and it might be his last. And right up here we are approaching the hippo pool. They've sank 6 of our boats in the past week, but it's all right. Only 5 of them were mine. Alright, as long as they stay under the water, we're fine, folks. It's when they come out of the water that we have a problem. We have a problem. Everyone, cover your ears. I think I scared them off. Alright, right up up here on the right-hand side, we have, oh, looks like Skipper Felix's boat has been taken over by some monkeys. That is not good. One of them's even on the mic though, so let's listen in and see if he's got any good jokes. Don't repeat that one, kids. Alright, then over here on the left-hand side, we have two monkeys in love. Aww, they're giving each other butterflies. And now, everyone, it is the moment you've all been waiting for. The amazing, astounding, eighth wonder of the world. It's the backside of water! Up here, it looks like there's some bones on the shore and on the beach, so we might want to be careful. Who knows what we're running into around this corner, but it might be something fishy. Alright, let's stop right here and... those are piranhas! Can you please remain seated, folks? Make yourself more of a target for these little fellas if you stand up. Alright, over here on the left-hand side, we have Fruit and Jam's gift shop slash lost and found. Would you believe that people just leave things in strollers out in the middle of walkways? All the stuff in them ends up right over here. Cheese. Yeah, the monkey can't work the camera, so you're probably never getting that one. Alright, give yourselves a round of applause if you have survived the world-famous Jungle Cruise! Woo! As we approach the dock, please remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the boat and watch all your little ones. You all have been an outstanding crew. I really mean that. You have been outstanding.
Head in the boat.
Head in the boat, please. Now I will have you outstanding on the dock. Thank you all so much. Have a great rest of your day. Please watch your head, watch your step, and use those handrails as you exit the boat. Watch your head, watch your step, and use those handrails.
about the words of dead men tell of dead. Salty old pirates, eh? Sure, you've come to the proper place. But keep a weather eye on the mates. And hold on tight. With both hands, anybody. There'll be squalls ahead. And Davy Jones waiting for them. What don't obey?
Your white flag, your scurvy scum, and ruining Now then, Frontier Land, Big Thunder Twin, and all the way up and all in square. This grand steamer, the Mark Twain, now accepting passengers and cargo for an authentic steam-powered journey up the rivers of America. Now, before we hide to come aboard, just a few reminders, please take your time. Look down, watch your steps. If you have small children, please take them firmly by the hand, help them on board. Also, folks, we ask you to refrain from smoking. Gambling, no doing the hard liquor aboard the Mark Twain. That means you too, Serena. We'll be boarding Mark Twain momentarily. One Mississippi, two Mississippi.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Mark Twain Railroad. I'll be your guide. The leadsman calling out the death markings so we can avoid running aground.
Mark Twain!
Mark Twain is not just the name of a riverboat or a great American author. It also means the water here is 2 fathoms deep. That means it's safe enough for us to proceed on our steam-powered journey along the rivers of America. On our trip, we'll visit the magnificent Columbia of the Great Northwest, the graceful Missouri of the windswept plains, and the rugged Rio Grande along the border of Texas and Mexico. I'll be sure to point out interesting sights along the way, and even tell you about a legend or two. We begin our trip right here on the mighty Mississippi, heading south and ending up down in New Orleans. History, music, good food, and ghost stories. One of those stories involves the old mansion you see over there on the hill. I've heard it said that the place is haunted, filled with 999 ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And they're looking for one more to make it 1,000. If you're brave enough, you should see for yourself after we arrive back at the landing in Frontierland. Passing Fowler's Harbor. This is homeport for the three-masted wind jam of the Columbia, the first American ship to circumnavigate the globe. Here's a bit of history for you. The Columbia set sail from Boston Harbor in 1787. She rounded Cape Horn and became the first American ship to carry the stars and stripes around the world. Beyond those levee walls on the port side is the Bayou, future home of Tiana's Bayou Adventure. Princess Tiana swears there's magic out there. And wherever you find magic, you're bound to find surprises. Blue skies and sunshine guaranteed. It's not quite finished yet, but we're almost there.
Dad told me fairy tales can come true.
Tiana's Bayou Adventure is part of Critter Country, a remote wilderness filled with tall pines and tall tales about local animals that talk, sing, play music, and dance. Don't you just love tall tales? While While you're in Critter Country, you might want to grab a paddle and try your hand at the Explorer canoes. You can work up a real good sweat rowing one of those around the river. Me? I'll take the comfort of a Mark Twain riverboat any day. As we head into the remote areas of the rivers of America, you're in for a real treat. I've been navigating these parts for years now, but I never get tired of taking in the breathtaking beauty of the Columbia River. The majestic trees, the stunning rock formations, the cascading waterfalls, the moose, deer, and elk along the banks. It's all so magnificent and so peaceful. Off to the side of the river is an Indian chief, and I do believe he's giving us a sign of peace. That means we're all clear as we head up the Missouri River to the home of the Plains Indians. Side is Pirate's Lair at Tom Sawyer Island, Young Tom always said he wanted to be a pirate, and I think I see why. If you're a pirate, you don't need to get up early in the morning and go to school. And you never have to wash your face and hands. All you have to do is just look for treasure all day long. At least that's what Tom Sawyer thought. Civilization along the Rio Grande. Off in the distance are the towering buttes of Big Thunder Mountain. Rumor has it that the railroad built to haul gold out of the mountain has been seized by supernatural forces, and they've turned the mining trains into the wildest ride in the wilderness. Of course, that may be just another legend of the river. Just ahead is the frontier land, where our journey ends. On behalf of our entire crew, I'd like to thank you for booking passage on the Mark Twain Riverboat. At this time, we ask that you prepare to disembark. If you're on one of the upper decks, please make your way down to the first deck. The stairways to the right side and the back of the boat may offer the quickest and easiest route. We hope you enjoyed your voyage with us and that you'll visit us again real soon.
Initiate pre-flight sequence. what's on deck three for Picard.
Right. Requesting heavy weapons authorization.
This does not look good. Try to find another way down to the escape pods.
The resistance will attempt to rescue the prisoners.
They have neither the resources nor the courage to engage us.
You underestimate their conviction. Raise the shields!
Shields? I see no evidence.
Now!
Came in a little off target. Ground crews will meet you outside the wreck.
All right, nice job, recruits. Not what you signed on for, but hey, your assistance now. I think I have that authority. Right, Beck? Where's the lieutenant? I need eyes on Beck. I know, scatter his copy.
Escape pod
down, Verification heading. Where's the lieutenant? I need eyes on Beck!
We're tracking that spot in the wreckage, sir.
Lieutenant Beck here! Beck!
I should hope so! Great job, recruits! Thanks to your heroism, the location of the resistance base is secure. Bravo! Yes, R5, you too.
Is where you come in. Oh, the Valerian.
find the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. Now get the move on and know that I have complete faith in you. But I am coming along with you just in case.
Time to get to work. Let's go, let's go. Make sure you're back.
Flight engineers, repair test. Hit your flashing buttons.
Flashing buttons, engineers.
Good job, engineers. Right, pilot, push the flashing button to take off. Pilot on the left, move your stick to fly right and left. I was just about to say that. Pilot on the right, pull back on the stick to fly up. And push forward to fly down. Oh, watch it! You think I'm flying this thing too easy, eh? Weapons are online. Left pilot, hit the boosters. Now let's go get that coaxial. Right pilot, make the jump to light speed.
Adorable children. We sail a true course, south by southwest. We'll be on our way when the wind has blown. One big blast and away we'll fall. So clear away the track, let the boat jam run. With the hay, ring a jig, it's a low back car. I'll be no more. Eyes on me, all on my feet. So clear away.
Do not touch the cannon on the front right side of the ship. Thank you.
When I come round to say farewell, I'll be no more. You won't stop to say goodbye and wish them well. So clear away the track, let the boat jam run. With the hay, ring a jig, give a low back car. I'll be no more.
Ahoy,
shipmates! We're
cleared the busy port of New Orleans and beginning our journey into the great American wilderness. Our vessel for this voyage is the proud sailing ship Columbia, the first American ship to carry the stars and stripes around the world. She's a 10-gun, 3-masted merchant ship. It was back in 1787 that she first set sail from Boston Harbor, going all the way around the Horn, then sailing onward to the Pacific Northwest, Hawaii, and China. In the 3 years it took us to make that journey, the Columbia was more than just a ship to us. She was our life and our home. Forward amidships is the main hatchway leading below decks, where you may see how we lived and worked on the high seas. The galley, captain, and crew's quarters are open for your inspection. For the rest of you, we invite you to stay up on deck, feel the wind in your face, and experience the wonders of this land we now know as America. Ship the Columbia was one of the first American vessels to explore the Pacific Northwest. It was in 1792 that this very ship braved a sandbar and discovered a mighty river, which we named the Columbia, after the first ship to sail our waters. Ahead is the most treacherous part of our journey. That island off the starboard side often hides the scourge of the seas, bloodthirsty pirates. They sometimes lie in wait to attack a passing ship such as ours and steal its bounty. Bowman, man the starboard forecastle cannon and prepare to fire a warning shot, so as any curious pirates hiding near the shore will know we are well armed. Those of you round the cannon best be stepping back, way back. For the cannon she be a mite loud, and the gunner's aim be a mite poor. Big credit to fire one. That should put some fear in them. Looks like we're safe for now, but I ask all crew and passengers to keep a weather eye out. We don't want the Jolly Roger flying above this fine ship. When we travel this far upriver, our ship often draws the attention of the local tribes. Look there. The chief has given us a sign of peace, which means we will be granted safe passage. This one have helped many an explorer learn how to survive in this vast frontier. It's time we be setting sail for home. Hold taut the flying jib. Brace for a starboard tack. Cook and helpers, stand by the puffs. 17 nighties lived and worked while on the high seas. The lower decks will be closing when we enter port. Those of you remaining on deck, keep a close eye on the riverbanks, where you may be able to see moose, elk, the last remains of an old shipwreck, rumored to carry a fortune in pirates' gold and secret midnight meetings. We'd best be sailing past this cove and back to civilization. Into the foot ropes. Furl the top gallants. Down with the flying jib. Make ready the bow anchor. Stand by all lines. Stand by the bow line, port side. Let go the bow anchor. Let go the kedge. Crew, it's been a pleasure serving with you aboard the sailing ship Canal. The first ship to carry the stars and stripes round the world. You've been a fine crew, and we hope you'll be sailing with us again soon. All hands! Prepare to go ashore!